So this is the Ghostbusters multiplayer. I'm here with Marty.
Howdy, hello.
And I'm going to hand it over to him to explain the multiplayer on this, since this is the first time I've ever played this. So over to you.
Okay. Well, obviously, as you know, you're playing as any of the four Ghostbusters, well, and the rookie as well. You've got the different game modes. You've got containment, which is what we're playing at the moment. It's pretty self-explanatory. You just kind of obviously have to try and trap the ghost, as Mike has just done now, and try and get as many in as the trap as you can to earn more money. Obviously, you earn more money as you rank, you carry on, and then every other rank, you get a new uniform. It's you know, obviously it's pretty fun. In the 4 years I've been playing this, it's you know, you always experience some great players. You know, they're not unfair. You get the odd one who's kind of goes for glory, but a lot of the time, you know, you get revived a lot, and there's some good people, you know, who play this. Definitely one of the most underrated multiplayer games on the 360. And if you love Ghostbusters, then, you know, what's not to love?
I was going to say, from my impressions of playing the game, I think it's an extremely underrated game in general.
I've
been really impressed with the...
Yeah, I mean, it got, you know, it got 8 out of 10 in reviews, but yeah, in terms of sales, you know, I think one of the main things that kind of hurt it was the fact that, obviously, the Americans got it first. It became exclusive because of the Blu-ray release, obviously, the PlayStation 3. It was released only on the PlayStation 3 early, and obviously the Xbox 360 in the same month. But luckily, they made it region free, which meant that us people in good old Blighty could play it as well, if you obviously acquired an illegal copy or you imported it. Not that I condone that kind of thing, but, well, not important. you know, so for all you naughty people out there who kind of pirated this game, then shame on you. You deserve to get bummed in prison, I guess.
Yes. I think that would discourage a lot of piracy if that was the actual punishment.
It probably would have affected sales, but I think obviously the fact that they made it exclusive as well kind of hurt it a little bit. So far, obviously, you're playing this, but you've been playing it for, what, 2 minutes? Got any kind of, like, views of it so far?
Well, first impression, it seems like a kind of a horde mode style game, I'm guessing.
It is, yeah. I'll explain the next game mode. I've only captured 3 ghosts. You do your proton stream as well gets upgraded every I think it's I can't remember how often it does. Depends how well you do. Obviously, you get ratings as well, and throughout the multiplayer, there are most wanted ghosts you can get, which pop up kind of randomly, or you have to like meet some kind of conditions. And obviously you get like a checklist of them, and once you've obviously unlocked them all, you get a nice little shiny achievement.
Nice.
This is Thief, and obviously you've got the 4 artifacts, which you can see in the centre of the screen there, and basically you've just got to stop all the ghosts from stealing them, you know, and it's another fun little mod where you kind of work well together. This map, it's quite an enclosed map. It's one of them which is, it's brilliant, but it is really, really frustrating at the same time as well, especially if you're doing survival. Survival's like hard mode. Oh god, they're stealing the artifact.
Oh,
where's he brought it? Oh. Ah, he's put it back. Where's the cherub? There he is. Ah.
Oh.
Yeah, it was, as Mike's obviously said, you know, you said it's very underrated. As is the multiplayer, really. You know, it's just, you know, it does get repetitive, but overall, It's one of the most fun kind of multiplayer games you'll get, and as I said, you don't really get... You don't tend to get anybody who just kind of goes for glory like you would on COD or Gears of War, or... And you don't get to get abuse either, you know. There's always some good players out there. I've always had a lot of respect for the community here, and it's good to see that people are still keeping it alive as well. That's... You know, it's a shame because they nearly did shut this down. The actual, for all the PlayStation 3 owners out there, the servers have been shut down, unfortunately. But they've oh, most wanted ghosts, this is what I'm on about. They have shut down the servers for the PlayStation 3, but they, due to public demand, they kept the servers open for the Xbox 360 version. So, obviously.
Oh, cool.
That's why we're here today.
Bringing that, that's one of the issues, I suppose, that could be a problem if, say, future generations of consoles did become online all the time.
How so?
They don't... Well, I mean, like you said, they shut down the servers for this on the PS3, so those who bought the game... At that point, I've still got the single-player game, but if you've gone online all the time and they shut down a server to your game, you know, there's the potential that you just won't be able to play that game anymore.
Yeah. Well, it's as you mentioned in the last podcast as well, for those who obviously haven't heard the podcast yet, obviously go to YouTube and on Crazy Horse and subscribe on Crazy Horse Gaming to watch it. Yeah, as you mentioned, obviously, you said the kind of, a lot of these sports games, for example, are shutting down the servers quite early, like FIFA, I think it was FIFA 11 recently, you mentioned that they're shutting down the servers for that. I think that and a few others as well. Seems to be EA who are shutting down the servers, and 2K Sports as well. Obviously, what's your view on that? You know, like, what's kind of, do you think, obviously it's fair, for example, a game that's only, you know, 2 years old, care to elaborate further?
I don't think it's fair in the slightest. I can understand the reason, or EA's reasoning behind it. I can see where they're coming from, as in, you know, we've made our money on this, we want to be moving on. But at the same time, you're paying full retail price for a game as a consumer, which isn't cheap. You know, you can't necessarily afford to keep up to date with, you know, the latest sports title.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So I think on that hand it's extremely harsh on the consumer with that kind of attitude of, we've made our money, let's shut the servers down and concentrate on someone else. I just don't think it's fair to the...
Oh, brilliant. Yeah, you just wrangle it in like that. Yeah, because there's kids who you know, the great thing is kids as well, especially these days, they won't always play like FIFA 12, for example, or FIFA 13. You know, they will go back and play FIFA 11. Kids don't care about kind of the latest kits and things like that. The kids really just prefer, you know, they just want to play a football game. You know, they're not bothered. I mean, obviously, if you've seen you'll know full well if you've seen the reviews of FIFA 13 for the Wii. Trust me, you want to read up on that. It's interesting reading, put it that way. Oh, and I have a message, but I cannot. And we've done it. We saved one artifact.
Is that good? Is that bad for this type of game? Or, you know, sitting there, I didn't
no,
have a clue
really,
what I was doing
considering
there.
Considering there's only two of us playing, it's not bad. It's a bit of a... As I said, it was one of the maps where it's kind of really close together, so you've got to try and, like I say, usually stick in the middle. We got obviously swamped by a lot of ghosts, so, you know, we actually did it. We didn't fail, as the victory screen says there. But, yeah, as you'll notice there on the screen, it says campaign cash, and... Career cash obviously is the main.
Yes.
Eventually, obviously, the campaign cash is just for this campaign, and the career cash is eventually what you use to rank up. Oh, this is survival. This is the hard mode. Obviously, teamwork is the key. It gets a lot more. There's 10 waves. Daughter is not 50. you're all right. And it's brilliant. It's, you know, eventually the enemies get harder, and on some maps you end up meeting old Mr. Staypuff himself.
Awesome. Not a Ghostbusters game without Staypuff.
Oh, aye. It was great in the main game that they kind of brought, you know, him back as well, and Slimer. And, you know, obviously the Grey Lady as well, Eleanor Twitty.
I was really impressed the way they managed to give it that movie-like feel to it. You did feel like you were in a Ghostbusters movie. Thank you kindly.
No problem. This is that most wanted ghost again. Got to try and kill it to get your checklist. Obviously for your checklist. Yeah, it's... You'll have it. I mean, I've already got it, but it's... Oh, you got it. Oh, God. These are the book golems. You might want to keep your distance from them if you can, because it charges towards you and it's a bit of a pain. To be honest, I'm probably going to be... it's probably going to kill me, actually. I'm the one warning you. That's what I mean. Just try and get a distance. There's also another separate game mode which doesn't appear in the campaign. It's called Slime Dunk, and you compete to obviously catch many Slimers against each other.
Ah, nice.
That's also brilliant. As you notice, you've got kind of the uniforms as well, which is a nod to kind of the TV show and the movies. There is a uniform I think you get maybe at rank 16 or something like that, which is the... if you remember the toys back in the day, I don't know if you collected them, you said before you were...
I did.
Do you remember the alternate figures where it's kind of like you press the head of something or whatever and their ears would pop out and things like that?
Yeah, I had the old lady.
Yeah, well, the one of the...
Whose mouth had dropped to the floor.
The real Ghostbusters, and the one I'm wearing at the minute is, obviously, you noticed the one from Ghostbusters 2. It's a bit of a geek reference there. Oh, God. Ah. These are a pain in the arse. You basically, to kill them, essentially just kind of wrangle them down once they get to red. Ah.
Keep that up and you'll be out of it.
Ah. Oh, I survived 4 waves. Seems like a quite well thought out multiplayer.
Pardon?
It seems like a fairly well thought out multiplayer.
I mean, it's more the fact that there's more maps, and like you said, you've got the most wanted ghosts and things like that. That adds to the longevity. Plus, you've got the achievements as well, if you're after them all. Speaking of achievements,
I'm always on the hunt for achievements.
You're competing, aren't you?
Well, you say competing, he hasn't got the chance of hell of catching me up. I let him think he's competing, but...
Sorry, achievement whore.
No game found.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, just to let you know, Mike has played Hannah Montana the movie and My Horse and Me Too. He just won't admit it.
That is not true.
He has. Just check his gamer card. He's got it on private for a reason. He doesn't want people seeing that.
I claim that as a lie. I haven't managed to find Hannah Montana yet. Still looking.
I'll lend you my copy if you want. Oh, sorry. I'll create another match. Do you want to try the slime dunk?
Yeah, why not? Sounds like it'd be a decent mode to try out.
Go to the menu again, and obviously try and find my match. Should be on there. It's instant, campaign. But it says you go on. I think it's from, like campaign or whatever. I forgot what the menu's called. Nobody else.
I found you.
Yay! Oh God.
Yes, my goal is before the real release of the next console, I want at least 100,000 on my gamer score.
What's that, sorry?
Before the release of the next console, I want at least 100,000 on my gamer score.
It's possible. Are there any kind of games? Have you got a backlog? I'll start the match now. Have you got a backlog of any games that you kind of you're looking to maybe boost that, or you're just kind of looking forward now?
I've got a huge backlog of games. I don't think any of them are easy boosters. I think I've played all of them.
You mean like TM, the Turtles for all the...
I finished that one ages ago.
Yeah, Finite Rain 3. It sounds like... Please tell me you haven't done the Avatar trick. I have not the Avatar, as in the Xbox Avatars. You know, the... whatever it is, The Last Airbender, or that game that came out, The Legend of Aang, or whatever, where you kind of, you can get 1,000 G.
Yeah, the 5-minute jobby. I did that one.
This is, like I say, you got to try and get them in the trap. They've got the traps all around, you don't throw your own trap.
Alright.
Can't see him now. He'll actually be easier to dunk.
Get in there. Whoa, what was that?
There is also another Xbox... There's an Xbox Live Arcade game called Ghostbusters Sanctum of Slime, although I wouldn't really recommend it. It's not great, to be honest. But I've just mentioned it, but it's, if you're a Ghostbusters fan, give it a go. Try the trial. The main one, I really want to get Blood Dragon Far Cry 3. That just looks amazing. I played the trial.
That does look awesome.
It's just a homage to the 80s. I mean, the 80s was like the best era for movies. I mean, you had, Return of the Jedi. You had Indiana Jones, you had this film, I forgot what it was, about these four guys, and they had like these hoovers on the backs, and they used to like hoover ghosts up. I think they were called like ghost dunkers or something like that.
Ghost hunters or something, aren't it?
Trappers.
Seekers?
You know the one I'm on about.
Sounds like a fairly decent idea.
Yeah, there was this giant, it was like, they had to kind of kill this giant marshmallow and things like that, and... apparently it didn't do that well, to be honest.
Not really a big catch on sort of thing.
No. Something about, I don't know, I keep hearing the song occasionally, something about who do you want to call or something like that.
He-Man or something?
Yeah, sounds familiar, At least you're getting the hang of this.
Yeah, I'm quite enjoying it.
I don't want to lose.
Why is my Slimer gold?
Oh! Alright, oh no, I thought that was one of the most wanted Slimers, but it's not. Ah!
to quite enjoying this. It's quite a fun.
It's great with four players. Steer my ghost. It's so unpredictable. I don't even know where he's gone. All right.
I'm calling shenanigans on that capture there.
You are too slow, old man. This slimer doesn't want to go in the trap. Pardon me. Oh! You want to play it that way, do you, bitch? I probably have choked out Mike by the end of this video, so, you know, obviously. Wasn't my fault. He had it coming. MVP! Oh, yeah! Do you want to do that one again? Or I'll let you decide.
Yeah, why? I quite enjoyed that one. Is there any other game modes we haven't seen yet?
Yeah, you've got obviously destruction. You've got to destroy these relics. Protection, which is, you know, it's pretty good. And that's it really. We can try destruction if you like. You've got to destroy these green relics, and there's also there's also orange ones as well. The orange ones, they generate like slime golems and big bad enemies, which, you know, which are really kind of between two of us, it's going to be tough. But do you want to give it a go?
Why not?
Sweet.
Why not? We'll show the full potential of the multiplayer. I mean, instant or campaign?
Not instant.
There we are. This has got me looking. Oh, we're playing this over the last couple of days. I've started looking up some of the older. So with me playing this the last couple of days, I've started looking up some of the older Ghostbuster games that were about.
Don't do it to yourself. The Mega Drive game was excellent. You know, I kind of watched the Angry Video Game Nerd video a few years ago of Ghostbusters, which is kind of like infamous now. And it made me go back and play the NES game. I used to play it on the NES, and yeah, it was shite.
See, I've got it for the Master System.
Oh, God. Yeah, I think it was Commodore Amiga as well, or Commodore 64. Yeah, Commodore 64. The thing is, though, it's kind of, you know, when you were a kid, it was like James Rolfe said, you know, it was like two of the greatest things ever in the 80s, like, you know, Nintendo and Ghostbusters. And then you kind of, you look back at all these games, like, you look back at the Ghostbusters games and you're like, yeah, this is brilliant, but, I mean, you play them now, it's like, this is awful. This for me was like Batman Arkham City in a way, and Arkham Asylum.
Yeah.
It was the first great kind of, like Arkham Asylum was a great Batman game, and there have been decent Batman games in the past, but you know, nothing as good as Arkham Asylum, and that's why this is like the first great Ghostbusters game. Hence why I would much rather have a Ghostbusters, you know, a sequel to this game rather than, you know, a third film. Terminal Reality did a great job on this, not Kinect Star Wars or that Walking Dead game, which I haven't played yet. I don't know, have you any interest in playing it, or?
I haven't played it myself, but a couple of the people I work with have mentioned it as being a god-awful, terrible game.
Have you actually played the Telltale one, Jex? I remember you saying in the last podcast.
I'm halfway through that.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought you said, have you not finished it yet?
No, I haven't got around to finishing it off yet.
Well, I mean, I thought you were halfway through it during the last podcast.
I haven't managed to get around to actually playing it. since. But yeah, I mean, I think that's one of the things that probably didn't help was the fact that Telltale's Walking Dead got such high regard and critical acclaim that there was no way they were going to live up to that.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, aye. The hell is trying to hit me? Alright, it's that one there.
Just picked up something new.
Yeah, you can get the different weapons. Like I say, if you can get the orange gun, which is obviously the Meson Collider, that you can destroy them quicker. If you can use the obviously the right trigger, but if you press the left trigger, it shoots the balls on dirt, which obviously like a big ball of fire that obviously instantly. That instantly kind of just gets rid of half of the energy. To revent at that. That was one of the things I said in the review, which is also you can use for Crazy Horse if you like. Reventing sometimes, you can be in the middle of trapping a ghost and then you have to revent and it's like, it can get a tad frustrating,
Yeah, it's like I was saying, playing the campaign, I went through it on professional straight away.
I bet you died a lot.
Oh, yeah. And the last boss was so frustrating.
Oh, Shandor, yeah. Shit, better go and revive you. Where are you? No, I can't get to you.
Oh. Thank you.
Alright.
Oh.
Cheers, mate. Actually, if you don't focus on the enemies, just focus on the relics. They're what are obviously generating the enemies, because the enemies actually disappear when you kill a relic, when you destroy a relic.
Ah, I see.
Yeah.
Right, so well, I'll forget you guys then.
I know, I just need to get rid of them. Ah. Yeah, I like the kind of nice blurred effect when you're kind of low on energy as well.
Where are you? There you are.
Cheers, me old mucker.
Alright.
Like I say, the red ones create the bigger enemies, so obviously if you can try and focus on them, you get that. That's like an invincibility orb.
Oh, sweet.
It's up here, where you've just run past. That's the green relic up here, where I am. Here you go. Just finding the other ones now. Oh, there's one up here as well. You'll see where my stream is. We're not doing too badly. I don't know how many we've actually destroyed. Probably about 12 or something like that. Oh, 18.
18?
Ah. It's a miss, but you got that. That's actually not too bad. Especially with two people as well. I think there's something like there's 26 in total to destroy. I think it's 26. So actually 18 in, for two people isn't bad. Do you want to try the other game mod?
Yeah, why not?
I know you've got kind of a feel for it. Is it something that you probably, you'd recommend to a lot of people and go back to yourself a lot, or maybe?
I think so, yeah. I mean, it's something that, like I was saying, I've rented this for obviously the look back purpose and things like that. It's something I'm considering buying. I think it's something I'd definitely go back and play again. Just for the multiplayer alone, I think.
Not thief. Protection, yep. I have created one.
Okie dokie.
An instant again as well. This one obviously you've got it's protection this, and it's I'll explain a bit more at the start of the match. Obviously I'll just wait for yourself now when you're ready.
Oh, yeah.
Here you go. As you'll be able to see there, it says activate and defend the PKE disruptors. You'll see them kind of flashing, they're like little beacons, and then you've got obviously the flashing there, as you can see on the screen in front. And you've got to protect them every time, obviously, your ghost gets near, it'll fire, you know, like a projectile, like slime or a nail gun, or it'll hit it if it's a big golem, for example. And you've got to charge it up to 100%, and there's four on each map. If you run out of time and you've still got any left, then it goes to sudden death. So here you go. As you can see, yeah. It's...
So kind of like a tower defense sort
it
of thing.
It is, yeah, in a way, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Wait for that to cause me to say, yeah. Has it not come close? Oh. We're on a trap down anyway, so, get in the trap. See that? Yeah, well, I mean, also, what's kind of your view of... It feels quite realistic as well, like, what's your view of the whole kind of wrangling and...
I quite like the wrangling, I think they've done a really good way of explaining how it all works and...
Yeah, definitely, with the, you know,
And, I mean, even if it's, like, say, for, obviously, people like us who were Ghostbuster fans back in the days who kind of know the basics behind it, it's obviously second nature, but for people who haven't seen a Ghostbusters film, which I imagine there's at least one or two people out there, it does a really good job of explaining it to them as well.
Huh? Alright, should be,
Nope.
Nearly actually charged, yep.
Awesome.
Oh, that was the same one. I just kind of... Right, the next one is down there, yeah.
Traps out.
These construction worker ghosts, if I fire, it's like... The whole kind of throwing the trap down and you know, it's like you say, it's kind of a nice little, it's little touches of authenticity that really do matter.
I don't know if you've ever watched on YouTube a guy called Guru Larry.
Guru Larry? I'm not entirely familiar. Why was...
He's obviously a gamer and Ghostbusters fan and a big movie fan in general. And he does a review, more like a show and tell sort of thing, of an actual Ghostbusters replica trap he bought from a licensed company in America who do full on reproductions of the movie props.
Matty collector's kind of like that. He collects the figures. Ah, no, I've never heard of him. Obviously, there is also, if you're a big Ghostbusters fan, there's the UK Ghostbusters. I mean, you get the cosplayers around the world. But yeah, obviously, for anybody who's kind of watching this in Britain, go to the UK Ghostbusters website and you'll see, obviously, the Ghostbusters fans, the UK section of the Ghostbusters kind of cosplayers, and they obviously they kind of turn up at events, and they're absolutely fantastic what they do. You know, I love seeing kind of, I've got, you know, obviously if you look at Crazy Horse, my pictures with a few obviously of the UK Ghostbusters, and oh, nice one, Mike. And yeah, you know, and it's that level of love and authenticity. It's kind of, Ghostbusters is maybe second to Star Wars in terms of being one of the biggest franchises of the 80s.
Oh, definitely.
And that's why, you know, just that level of attention to detail, you know, with everything they do. I'll check him out on YouTube, but...
It's a British fella, right? And the replica he got looked like it was straight out of one of the movies. Sound effects, lighting, even the trap was on wheels with a proper cable and everything, it looked astounding.
This looks like it's gonna go to sudden death.
Get in the trap.
This looks like it's gonna go to sudden death. Be fast.
I mean, what I like about this game and all is they've done really well not to make it look and feel like a run-of-the-mill shooter.
Yeah. Definitely. I mean, you've got obviously that the kind of rule one as well in there as well. That also kind of does affect, you know, you can't just run in front of everyone's streams, and obviously it does kind of hurt your characters as well. Yeah, so they've kind of got that kind of nailed down. Yeah, like you say, it's an unlicensed nuclear accelerator on your back, as opposed to just, like you say, a shotgun, or I don't know, you know, like in your kind of run-of-the-mill shooters like Battlefield or Call of Duty or anything like that. Not that there is anything wrong with Call of Duty or Battlefield or, you know, whatever. I better not speak too soon, because the next time I play this, I'll probably end up getting charged microtransactions. I'll have to buy like each part of a proton pack for like, I don't know, 800.
You said the unforgivable word there.
Microtransactions.
Yes.
Yeah, it's, you touched upon that in the last podcast. Yeah, there is a Ghostbusters game for iOS, not on Android yet. For anybody, obviously, who's kind of going on the YouTube comments going, oh, why is it not on Android? Yeah, it's not on Android. It's made by Beeline, and basically, it's a fun little game. But anyway, the point is, you start off with just a normal team of Ghostbusters, but if you want to buy Ventman, Stunt, Spengler, and Zedmore, it costs 50 power cores each, and you've got to grind to get the power cores. But if you want to get them early, you can, however, spend money. And it's not required to, but, you know, it depends how badly you want everything.
And it kind of also gives you the idea of just how much do they scale that grinding up to make you get them.
I've been playing for months and I've got like 49 power cores now. It kind of, you know, it depends on whether you really, really kind of need it, to be honest. How badly do you really want, you know, it's like Candy Crush Saga. That's a big thing at the minute. I mean, don't get me started on that. My fiance is playing it. She absolutely loves it. I just think it's Bejeweled.
Yeah, so does my wife.
She argues with me. She's like, it's nothing like Bejeweled. It's better. I'm like, it's basically...
It is Bejeweled.
It is. Bejeweled set standards, you know.
It's Bejeweled with a different picture over the top.
Yeah, you might have variants, you know, but to be honest, though, Bejeweled kind of copied Columns in a way. You know, Columns was the original Bejeweled. So, yeah, you know, obviously, but, you know, and the point is, yeah, you know, they're charging for all these lives and things like that, and it's like, in a way, though, I'd much rather people get into bloody debt than bloody keep pestering me on Facebook. The amount of people I've had to block. Not that I'm condoning a new recession, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. You know, coming begging in the streets for me saying I had to, I've had to sell my house because of of my Candy Crush addiction.
Candy Crush.
Yeah. No.
You sat outside a McDonald's Wi-Fi with your phone.
Exactly, yeah. I couldn't even afford to pay in Sky this month, yeah.
Well, before we go down that rabbit hole, I think we'll call it there for the video purposes. But
still like a busker. Please.
Need me money for me bejeweled.
You sir, you'll next see it on one of them adverts on Lenny Henry. He won't be going over to Africa. He'll be going over to Essex. This is Dave. Dave had it all, and then he got Candy Crush Tiger on his iPhone. And now for just 69p a week, you can afford to give him new lives. He's just no.
So many millions of people are affected by Candy Crush-itis a year.
It's going to be rehab. There is going to be a rehab for that. But yeah, the old microtransactions, it's just... Oh, I'm going to start a campaign. But yeah, the whole microtransactions thing, it's like, it's slowly creeping into our, like, Dead Space 3 and what's the other one? Battlefield, is it? Sorry?
See, like I mentioned on the podcast, if you're paying full retail price for a game, there should be no excuse for having microtransactions in there.
Well, that's why I have these free. Oh yeah, you want to search for a game? I've created one. Sorry. You've got exactly. You've got you've paid, like you say, these free games, obviously, or freemium. We got another one in there. Have you found my game or?
I'm looking now.
I'll wait for you. Are you actually coming in?
Is it still instant or campaign?
Campaign.
Alright, there we are.
I'll start it in a sec, while.
Alright, well, I think we will call it there for this video, but no doubt we'll continue playing for however long we continue playing. To the audience, we'll say goodbye now, and we will catch you all in the next video.
Yeah, definitely.
So that's goodbye from me.
Goodbye from me as well, and it's been a pleasure.
Yeah, thanks for watching.